In this video, we will walk you through how to edit and display images using various block types. For example, the image block, the gallery block, the slideshow block, and the cover block. But let's start with the image block. Use the image block to add a single photo. To add one, click the plus icon, top left, and search image. Or you can use the shortcut and type /image and then insert the block. You can upload a new file from your computer, select one from your media library, as well as a few other options. For example, adding images from your Google Photos account and using royalty-free images from Pixels. When adding images from your computer, please take note. JPEG and PNG are the most common image file types you can add. WordPress also supports other file types, for example, WebP. You can find a full list of supported file types on the support page. Make sure your images are large enough, otherwise it will appear blurry when loaded on a website. At the same time, make sure it's not too large, otherwise it will load slowly for your visitors. While there is no one-size-fits-all, here are some guidelines that will help. I suggest pausing the video and reviewing these sizes. I will go ahead and add an image from my media library. Once selected, we can resize the image by dragging the corners. And then you can use the block toolbar to perform multiple tasks. You can change the alignment to, for example, wide width or full width. You can also add duotone to create a two-tone color effect without affecting the original image. If you want to return to the original image, just click clear. Next, you can also hyperlink your image. Next to that, I will click on the cropping feature. And then you can, for example, select an aspect ratio and apply the crop. And then there's even an option to turn your image block into a cover block if you want to add text over the image. I will undo for now, as we will get back to the cover block in just a moment. You can also use the block toolbar to add a caption if you want to, or choose not to display it at all. Next to captions, there's a cool AI feature where you can generate alt text. Alternative text is a short description of the image to help screen readers and search engines understand the image. This contributes to improved accessibility and SEO. And finally, you can also use the block toolbar to quickly replace the image. Next, to style your image, open the sidebar settings on the right. Here you can manually add your alternative text, and below that you can update the image's aspect ratio to, for example, standard, tall, etc. Alternatively, if you want to get precise with the image's dimensions, you can adjust the settings below width and height. Enter the desired dimensions in pixels. Remember to also update the resolution to full size for the best image quality. When you open the Styles tab, you can choose between the default or a rounded style. And below Filters, you can also add Duotone, the same as in the Block toolbar. And below Dimensions, you can add margin to your image, more space around the border of the image. Let's see this in relation to other blocks and increase the horizontal margin, or the space around the border. And at the bottom, you can also add a border and, for example, update the color of your border. And then you can always reset your changes. You might also decide to add a radius to your image to give it more of a rounded effect. And finally, you can also add various types of drop shadows. Did you know you can use the media and text block to place an image to the left or the right of text? To add the block, we can use the shortcut /media and text and then insert the block. Then you can upload an image. I will go ahead and select a royalty-free image from Pixels. Then you can insert any other block. For this example, I will go ahead and add some text. To select the main media and text block, click on the left of the block toolbar. And then you can, for example, change the alignment to wide width. And you can use the block toolbar to show the media on the right, or the left. And you can update the vertical alignment of the text to bottom, top, or middle. In the sidebar settings on the right, you can also increase or decrease the media width. And if you want to style the block further, make your way to the Styles tab. You can even display images in columns. Once you add your columns block, you can select the number of columns you need. In this case, we'll go for 3 equal columns. Then, click on the left of the block toolbar to select the main parent block. Or it will be helpful to open the list view, and then you can select individual columns or the main column. When you select the main parent block, you can use the block toolbar to change the alignment to, for example, wide width. Then we can go ahead and select the first column and add the image block and upload an image. In this case, I will upload an image from my media library. And then we can repeat the process. When you open the Styles tab, you can style the block further. And if you click on the Settings tab, you can change the amount of columns you want. In this case, I will increase it to 4 and then add another image. Then we can select the main columns block again. And in the block toolbar, if you click on the 3 vertical dots, you can duplicate the column if you want another row of images and then just update it accordingly. When you select an individual image, you can use the block toolbar and sidebar settings for the image block as seen before. If you want to showcase multiple images in one spot, you can use the gallery block. Once I add the gallery block, I will select multiple images from my media library. And once selected, we can go ahead and create a new gallery and insert it into our page or post. Then I will click on the left of the block toolbar to select the main gallery block. Or you can, of course, use the list view. Then I will use the block toolbar to change the alignment to, for example, wide width. You can also use the block toolbar to hyperlink your gallery block, add a caption, or add more images. In the sidebar settings on the right, you can decrease or increase the amount of columns you want in your gallery to suit the layout you want. Then I'll make sure I select the parent block again, and then below resolution, we can update it to full size. Something else you will notice is that crop images to fit is automatically enabled to ensure images are the same size. If you prefer, you can turn this off. When you make your way to Styles, you can update the background color of the gallery block. And when you click on the 3 vertical dots next to Dimensions, we can, for example, add padding or margin. In this case, we'll select padding and add some horizontal and vertical padding around the images. It is also a quick step to reset any changes you have made. Below Dimensions, you also have the option to remove or add spacing between your blocks. You can have 0 block spacing, as in this example, or you can tweak it as you prefer. And right at the bottom, you can also add a border or a radius to your gallery. And when you select an individual image, you can style it accordingly. Please remember, you can choose from various gallery patterns. Patterns are pre-made designs or layouts that you can insert into a page or post and then customize with your own content. To explore some of the available gallery patterns, click the plus icon top left, select the Patterns tab, and search for the gallery category. Then you can browse through the available patterns and click the one you like to insert it into your page or post. And then you can go ahead and add your own images. Click Replace in the block toolbar and select a new image. And once updated, your gallery pattern is ready. Something else that is really cool is that you can transform your gallery block into a different format. When you click on the top left of the block toolbar, you can transform this block into, for example, a slideshow block, which you can use to display multiple images in sequential order with transition effects. In the sidebar settings on the right, you can turn on autoplay and choose between two transitions, slide or fade. But maybe you have a different format in mind. We'll click on the top left of the block toolbar again, and this time select the tiled gallery format. In the sidebar settings on the right, you can add rounded corners. And when you click on the little star icon in the block toolbar, you can add an image filter, for example, sepia or even 1977. Lastly, we get back to the cover block. The cover block is great for adding a visual header or a striking section with the text overlaid on an image or video. As seen earlier, we could transform an image block into a cover block, but if you start from scratch, type /cover and select to insert. Upload or select a background image. Then add your heading or call to action directly on top. You can add any other type of block on top of a cover image. I will go ahead and add some text. Click on the top left of the block toolbar to select the main cover block, and then use the block toolbar to change the alignment. You can add a duotone effect. You can also change the content position to, for example, top left, middle bottom, or elsewhere. Additionally, you can toggle your cover block to full height, but you can also drag the block manually to enlarge or decrease. Next, I will select the text and enlarge it in the sidebar settings below font size. If you want your text to span across your cover block, you can deselect the option in the block's Use Content Width. Next, below Settings, we can select Fixed Background if you want to create that parallax effect. The Repeat Background option is useful when an image isn't the size of the space it fills. Below that, you will find the Focal Point Picker, and that is helpful when you are trying to identify the most important visual point of an image, especially for mobile viewing. Then we can make our way to styles. At the top, you can change the overlay color of your image, and you can increase or decrease the opacity to make the overlay color darker or lighter. Below filters, you can also add a duotone, and then below dimensions, you can add a bit of padding or space around the content within your block. And then we can close the left sidebar to get a better view. It is also important to preview how your cover block appears on a mobile device. I think the text is too big, so I will go ahead and decrease the size. When selecting an image for the cover block, it is advised to use a decorative or abstract image, since the full image may not always display in full on mobile devices. Now that we've seen what's possible with these blocks, the rest is up to you. Use them to tell your story, showcase your work, and bring your creative vision to life.